This is a bad idea. I don't think I can make that jump. Nope. Let's see. We can actually climb out, though, I think. So this shouldn't be too bad. Modders making this the game that Bethesda originally intended. Man, that is gonna be nuts. All they need to do is add like a bunch of just side activities. Like, oh hey, you wanna like do trading caravans or something? You can do that. Basically just make it like a fantasy world simulator, essentially. Yeah. Like that's the thing is I think like a lot of people like look at this game and they don't... Oh, that was bullshit. They don't realize just how big Daggerfall is, like how much is in this game. All it needs is like polished. And then this could be like, yeah, some absolutely amazing thing. Did you just fucking throw a paralyzed spell or was that an ow? Get out of here, ghost. Nobody was talking to you. I was taunting the scorpion and contemplating whether or not I can make this jump. Oh! Never a doubt in my mind. Seriously. Seriously? Where's my freaking cargo cloak? That would be pretty crazy. I'm curious though how much that, like some doing something like that would cost. Blockham Tower. A really cool room. I have no idea where I'm expected to go in here. It's just really nifty. Tell you, I want to get over here. No. Jump off. There we go. Just a door to the main area? Yes. Okay. Ooh, magic claymore. Can't use it, but magic item. I don't know why, but this area reminds me of fucking Battle Spire for some reason. Oh man, like, what in the, oh, that's one of those like damaged sectors. Every time I get into one of those things, it like freaks me out because I'm like, what's dealing damage to me? And I try to move to avoid it and then it kills me. The floor was in fact lava. That's okay. We'll just jump in and I won't move. We'll beat this thing to death. Open the door. Locke has nothing to fear from me. There. Room full of treasure. Alright. Yeah, Battle Spire was certainly a thing. Challenger straps reacquired. But yeah, like, having... Oh, we're gonna die. But yeah, like having a room like this in a dungeon in tabletop, holy shit, that would be a nightmare to run. It could be really cool, like it would be a very dynamic fight, but damn. I mean, I'm working on getting a tabletop put into our basement here. I'm just essentially waiting to get it into the house. It's built and everything. And my wife and I are going to be doing like wargaming on it and stuff. And that comes with terrain building, so like I would love to build something like this, but holy crap. It'd be a nightmare. Spell effect failed. Cargo cloak, quit failing me. Cargo cloak! William Wallace? There we go. Ugh. Recipe for a potion of resist frost. Okay. Okay. Nah, I can get behind that. We pluck arrows from the corpse. What I'm looking at is, like, you go to, like... I don't even know what the equivalent would be over in Europe, but, like, here we have, like, a Home Depot, like, a store that sells, like, you know, construction supplies, like, if you want to build, like, wood stuff. And so on, like, home improvement stuff. And you buy XPS foam, and you, like, carve it into terrain. And then paint it. And that's probably what I'm gonna do. And yeah, stuff that's, like, more 3D is kind of what I'm aiming for. Like, I know some people go insane, and they'll build, like, whole cities worth of stuff with the foam. And I'm just like, I just want to build, like, kind of, like, set pieces, you know? Like, here's, you know, an altar and a dais that are, like, the altar sitting on the dais, and you can plop that down, and you're like, yeah, this is 5 feet higher, and do stuff like that. Maybe, like, some ledges, some, like raised walkways and stuff. I think that could be cool. And I mean, I do have a 3D printer. I have 3D printed some terrain. Well, not terrain. I've printed, like, dungeon dressing. Like, I've printed out, like, pillars and stuff. A lot of boxes, barrels. And it turns out okay. Like, it's not super crazy high quality. But it's more than adequate for a tabletop game. And, yeah. Like, there is some crazy stuff. Like, they have, like, if you want to 3D print a building, you can 3D print a building. Even, like, modular buildings and stuff, it's just that the print times on them are pretty nuts. Like, if you want the ground floor of a structure, it's, like, 50 hours of printing, which, I mean, it's kind of a passive activity, so it's not a big deal, but at the same time, it's like, holy shit, that's 50 hours of printing. But that's a maybe. It depends. I want to try making stuff with the XPS foam first to see how much of a pain in the ass it is, and then go from there. Okay, so that goes way the hell up. Oh, is that gonna... No, that's not gonna take us all the way back to the entrance. Looks like it's gonna deposit us... Actually, nowhere... Oh, it's going higher than the entrance. Holy crap. Alright. I'm not gonna worry about it yet. We'll diddle with that later. Yeah, like, I gotta get a picture of it up on my Discord at some point.
Cheese for everyone!
Goddamn cheese. I printed out a bunch of, like, pegboard things that I can slot into pegboard, because, like, I paint miniatures in my free time for, like, tabletop gaming. And I have, like, a shitload of paints and stuff, and I never had a good way to organize them, so I went out and bought a fucking sheet of pegboard and printed out a bunch of paint holders and put those on it. And it's like, fuck yeah, this is, like, super organized and everything. It's wonderful. But yeah, it's pretty great. I've tried printing miniatures with it, but it just doesn't have the fidelity. If I wanted to do, like, miniature printing, I would need, like, a resin printer, and they're too much of a hassle for the size of the house that I live in. Because they have, like, you have to watch out, like, for resin fumes and stuff, and, like, I print stuff in our basement, so it's not exactly, like, well-ventilated. And that's okay with PLA, because it's just, like, corn starch and sugar, so, like, it doesn't smell unpleasant when it's doing it. But with, like, resin, you gotta be careful of the fumes and stuff, and, eh. Exactly, and it works. Just buy another house purely for all of my 3D printing, yes. Storage units would likely be the way to go, like, where I am. Like, there's a place that rents them out a short drive away, but then it comes down to having to buy the 3D printers and rabble, rabble, rabble. And in the long term, it is substantially cheaper. But I think for the time being, I would rather just, like, you know, pay $3 or $4 for a miniature and just paint it. For now. Whoa. Hello, random ghost. No idea where that thing came from. Okay. Let's see. Looks like this way is uncharted territory and it is a dead end. All right, I'd say we're probably done here. So let's go ahead and... God, that lighting is so good. Have a nap. Enemies? Who dares? Freaking things spawning in from the aether. Holy shit! This lady must have been an owl. Oh, that's the wagon. I was gonna say, like, she just had a shitload of... How was I in my wagon? What even? I shouldn't even be able to access my wagon. Weird. Cause yeah, I should have to come in here to access my wagon, not be able to dink around with it. Video games. Oh, going with some Warhammer painting. Games Workshop makes really nice models. I just wish they didn't charge so much money for them. Yeah, that is the sole thing that keeps me from going heavier into like Warhammer. Tips for starting? Oh god. Your first minis are gonna be shit, and you need to accept that, and you will get better and quickly at first, and then it'll slow down. Don't necessarily buy the best brushes in the world to start with. You don't need them. You can paint minis pretty good with brushes that you can buy at like a craft store, like Hobby Lobby or whatever. Like, the brushes that I use for the majority of my base painting on minis are like $6 brushes you can get at Hobby Lobby. I have expensive brushes for detail work, but generally you don't need those for everything. When it comes to mini painting, brand loyalty will get you fucked. Do not be afraid to shop around for different brands of paints, different manufacturers of miniatures, etc., etc. Let's see, always prime your minis before you paint them. If you want like a darker, if you want a prime that kind of hides your fuck ups a little better, go with black, but be wary that if you go with black, then it's harder to paint. Like, this sounds like it would be like a doy thing, but when it comes to painting over black, it's harder to paint certain colors than others because of how pigments work in the paints. Yellows, reds tend to have some serious issues with coverage when it comes to painting over black. I tend to prime in dark gray, and that kind of is the best of both worlds. Let's see. If you buy minis that are cast in molds, so basically like non-games, if you buy a mini and it doesn't come on a sprue, be sure to wash it before you prime it, because they have mold release agent on them and it will fuck up your primers. You should generally wash your minis before you paint them regardless, but specifically worry about it on minis that don't come on sprues. Warm soapy water and a toothbrush will carry you far. And yes. Be sure to have like some things floating around that you don't mind destroying. And a wet palette. A lot of people suggest getting a wet palette. They help with blending. I personally don't use one, but that's mostly because I'm a forgetful ass and I know I would leave it somewhere and it would turn into some moldy horror. Let's see. Washes. Get washes for your miniatures. There are two primary manufacturers for them. Games Workshop does washes. They call them shades, I believe. And Army Painter does washes. Both brands are good. Generally speaking, I would say grab Nuln Oil and Agrax Earthshade from Games Workshop. And I think Dark Shade from... Army Painter, and that will cover the grand majority of stuff you'll probably be doing to start. Yeah, and yes, Games Workshop is pricey in a lot of ways. When it comes to primers, you can either use brush on or rattle can, like a spray can primer. I personally lean towards rattle cans. But depending on like the weather in your local area, if it's like super hot or super humid, it can kind of cause issues with them, and you might want to use brush-ons. Get good lighting. That's another thing. Do not be afraid to spring on like a good lamp, or even one with like a magnifier on it, just so that you can see like what you're painting. It makes a surprising difference. And exactly, that's exactly it. Start cheap, but don't go like mega cheap, or you're gonna probably regret it and have a bad time. And hey, look, there's that mithril mace I was whining about for so long. Yeah, miniature stuff, like the whole hobby of miniature craft is, you can go fucking deep into it if you want. You can spend absurd amounts of money on it, but you don't have to have a good time. Like, go out and buy, like, Go on to like Amazon or your equivalent and buy one of Reaper's Learn to Paint kits. They're like $30 or $40 US. They come with like a couple miniatures, a brush and some paints, and like a little guide to take you through painting your minis. And that'll give you, if nothing else, it'll kind of show you whether or not it's something you're gonna have a good time with. And that should suffice. Exactly. And like one thing to keep in mind, and it's something that I struggle with, is like, just because like if you paint a mini and you're not happy with how it looks like under close scrutiny, that doesn't necessarily mean that it's gonna look bad in tabletop play, because you got to remember that a lot of minis are like, you're viewing them generally like about 3 to 4 feet away from you. So, you know, if you might have like kind of gone out of the lines a little bit here or there, you're not gonna notice it in play. Like under close scrutiny, yeah, but eh. Don't worry too much about it, unless you're going for like you're painting for a competition or whatever. Then it's like hardcore, you know, break your own fingers doing stuff. Exactly. And the thing is that like even like a model painted by someone who's new to the hobby is, once you've kind of gotten your foundations down, it's gonna look better than any pre-painted model you buy, like by WizKids or whatever. So, like, even with, you know, only maybe like 10 minis under your belt, you're gonna be painting models that look better than stuff you're gonna be able to buy. So, it's not bad. And you'll be slow at first. Don't be surprised if like your first miniature takes you like 3 or 4 hours to paint. Given enough time, you'll be able to crank out minis really rapidly. Exactly, and you will be proud of your minis. Exactly. And you know, you can always have a mini for like that boss that you're going to murder half your party with and stuff. And like, that's half of the fun of it, is like you're looking at minis in a store and you're thinking of all these stories that you can tell with them. All right, we got some challenger straps. I need to see what equipment slot these things take, because I'm gonna make them into some. Oh, we can wear them under our gear? Oh no, we have straps of the Orc Lord on, which give me Orc strength, which does not stack with my werewolf strength. So what are these things? 10 points, oh man. Well, I mean, if you got a local gaming store, just go poking around, just ask around. Like, for the most part, gamers are pretty welcoming. I mean, they're the jerks floating around, but you get that with any hobby. But for the most part, like, people will just be excited that you're interested in the hobby. Oh, I could get slow falling, but that might be a pain in the butt. I like to have running all the time. Water walking could be good. Increased weight allowance would make sense. Carrying capacity. What else? Repairs my stuff. And around or generate health all the time. Why does it gotta be so expensive? Enhances my skill at restoration magic? There we go. And how about destruction? These are gonna be like the most beefy straps ever, but they're gonna be like everything is terrible and everyone hates you. Oh yeah. No, I don't want bad rep with all, I don't think. Bad reactions from everything. Right, I gotta have enough room. Because I think we can only do five things. I know we can get six. There we go, look at that. Alright. God, what are these? These are the, I don't even know. There, the probably OP straps of hatred. Bam. So now all of our skills are gonna be really good. How much is Band-Aid down to? Yeah, 5 spell points for casting a Band-Aid. Cure Light Wounds is reasonable. Our fucking death magic is still ridiculously expensive and I hate everything, but... decent starter. Let's see what you got. What do we have here? Yeah, Space Marines. That's not a bad set. Let's see what that is. US dollars. Four. Come on, currency conversion for 40 bucks. Yeah, that's reasonable. Like, generally. Yeah, 10 minis for roughly 40 US dollars. Generally, personally, I try not to pay more than like $4 or $5 a mini. And that can be challenging with Games Workshop. But like, that's a decent price for what you're getting there. And their models are very nice. Like, Games Workshop's models are very high detail. You're gonna have to probably put them together, so get like some super glue. And get comfortable with using it, and try not to glue your fingers to everything. Don't you do it. Oh my god. Get out of here. But, yeah. You should have a good time with them. One thing I will say, paint-wise, I like Reaper's paints for their colors, but I don't like Reaper's metallics. I think Games Workshop has probably some of the best metallic paints out there. They've got really good, like, pigment density to them. We did also get a note. We're a thief. Do not try to deny it. We've been seen in the act. Alright. Steal from Eodric from the Yomheart residence and Kalumbaisa if we desire to join. Yeah, I'll pass on that. We're two-thirds of the way towards a level. Oh my god, yes. Yes, absolutely. Everybody's gonna drink their paint water once, and anybody that says that they haven't is a fucking liar. It's like peeing in the shower. Everybody does it. The trick is to only do it once. Alright, I am looking for the innkeeper. You? Yes. Room! Give me one for 90 days. Or 190 days, whatever. I'm just here to cast Band-Aid a lot. I'm gonna level my restoration. I'm curious what happens if we cast like a healing spell and it reflects on us. Does that like affect NPCs or whatever? Oh, here's happy drunk guy drinking his ketchup. There's no flautist though. Oh, not a coffee drinker. That's okay. Whatever your beverage of choice is, keep it away from your your paint mug. A lot of people that I know try, they lean towards, like, bottled drinks. Like, just have a bottle of water with a screw on top so that there's an action in addition to just picking it up and drinking. And that tends to help. I just keep my drink on my left and my paint mug on my right, and that's worked okay. Oh man, we're gonna be here forever. Hey, there it goes. 72. Alright, 73% towards the next level. Oh man. I'm actually... I wonder if they have the bug in this where you can, like, buy a boat and just use that to win the game. Where you, like, buy the boat and jump off of it and it, like, glitches the terrain. I can't imagine that made it across. I would hope that that's something that they'd have fixed. Yeah, we're basically just gonna have to sit here and zap stuff. Cause, like, we have to get to level 10. Cause the game is refusing to give me that quest. Just if possible? I mean, we could. Let's see, Daggerfall, boat glitch. Let's see. Boat. You're running across water. Finding random dungeons. I don't know. I'll have to do some research. I don't necessarily want to, like, speed run the ending of this, though. I might have to refer to my original run to figure out where Lysandus' tomb is, because we're not gonna know, but I can do all the quests up to that point, and then we can just hoof it there. Yeah, I'll probably do some looking into that, assuming I recall to do so. But we'll see. This is, after all, what I would consider a lighthearted run. I'd hoped it made more progress tonight than we did, but we've done, like, everything that we can based on where we are in the game right now. Got a bad memory, too. Yeah, I mostly just take a lot of notes and hope I don't forget anything important. It works for the most part. Smart. I just have, like, post-its everywhere. Let me see. Boat. Damn it. Typing is hard. Daggerfall boat exploit. Yeah, the only one that I'm seeing on that, at least on the unofficial Elder Scrolls pages, is how to, like, get infinite gold by exploiting the boat, respawning shop inventories. Oh yeah, that's great. 86%. Only a couple more resto levels and we'll ding, 9th level. Holy crap. Draw a map. Yeah, there you go.